we're back.
GSL Venus Tasteless, one of my favorite planets.
Yeah, Venus is a good planet.
Did you know that if we were to colonize another planet, everyone's like, yeah, man, Mars. No, actually, if we would build a floating platform above the clouds of Venus, and that would be the best place in another planet in our solar system for humans to live.
I'd make mine on IR.
I like give this awesome, amazing fact that so few people know, and Tase is just like,
yeah, I just like botch
it like
with a
Jim Raynor, and I'm like, what about Jim Raynor?
Jim Raynor. Listen, you hater nerd. I'm being funny, all right? You didn't beat a single player. The map is Zelnaga Fortress. We already went to their caverns. Next map, Zelnaga. Zelnaga's barbecue party. Like.
It would make sense that the Zelnaga invented Zerg, Protoss, and barbecues. Three things I don't really like.
You actually barbecue mushrooms. People don't know that, but you actually
mushroom barbecue, man.
You just like you say like you don't like it, then the next sentence you're like, I do like it.
I played Zerg and Protoss.
I'll say whatever it takes to be cool, is what you're saying. I've had enough.
I'm a total follower nerd.
It's time for game number three. Gumiho against Oz, and right now Gumiho is opening up a can of whoop-ass. Can Oz stop that? Or is that a Costco-sized can of whoop-ass? We're going to find out here at the GSTL. Over here in the red, I forgot to introduce him.
Epixel Zu.
No, it's Oz.
Zu.
Somebody's going to say, no, it's Zed. No.
It's not Zed.
By the way, I know we had an argument about this in a previous cast. Color not spelled with a U. You're wrong. Yep. Over here in the blue.
Gumiho, Poyu.
Last time we did that in a cast, I got somebody writing me on Twitter being like, I'm from England and we invented the expletive language. Like,
yeah.
It was like it was crazy.
Must have been a joke. No one can be.
And he was an insecure nerd. Insta nerd. No, I can't actually connect him.
Let's come back to that. We'll figure something out for it.
But you know what? I am in person artosis. Remember we do the signings at
yes.
The. Oh my God! Hold on a second. This is unstable. Whoa! 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 I just moved through time with how many shots we got. That's Wolf.
All right.
Here's the thing is, Wolf looks more like a vampire than a wolf, or a werewolf.
That's actually, you know what? He looks like a vampire.
We talked about this. Yeah,
I've never seen him during the day. Oh, wait, I have seen him during the day. Never mind. Never mind, Taze.
I'll tell my other funny story when we have a break. We're in this game now, and I'm a little bit worried for Oz. Oz played well in the last Team League game until he got too greedy.
Yes. That's actually very, very true. We've seen a lot of greediness, Tasteless. People are greedy. Not everyone's...
It's one of the seven deadly sins.
Yeah, man.
Did you see the movie Seven?
Like, forever ago.
Dude, that movie's so good.
I remember thinking it was really good when I saw it, but it was, like, so long ago that if you were to tell me a scene, I might not remember it. Except for the part where the guy cut off his own side fat or whatever. His love handle, he, like, cut it off. It was, like, 7 pounds of, like, gluttony or something like that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I remember that.
That's the one that I remember from when I saw it.
No, I thought the gluttony one, he just ate so much food that he...
No. No, I think I'm right. Unless that was 12 Monkeys that I'm thinking of. It was definitely...
12 Monkeys is the greatest movie.
The greatest?
Of all time.
What about Star Wars Episode 1?
That was not as good as... hold on.
Oh, that sellout was so close.
He was so close, man.
He, like... was breathing and the Marine felt on the back of his neck. He got the sickest chills. He's like, I'm about to take 16 damage! And the Zealot turned around. All right.
Oh, he chose this.
Yes.
So, you know, the Marine and the Marauder are just going to continue to chase him. And we don't have concussive shells on the way here. But that'd be scary if that was the case. Second gateway. Probably
actually, he got
a little
concussive
bit of
shells.
Oh, he
and
did.
He's getting
did I miss stemmed.
That?
Yeah. It, oh, I'm sorry.
Well, excuse upgrades me. In two blinks of an eye.
Yeah, it's a pretty quick upgrade.
It is. All right, so we do have Z, or Oz, I guess, going up to three gates. He got his second gas pretty quickly. So he'll be able to make a decent number of centuries if he likes. I expect
this
build's
actually pretty good.
Yeah,
getting three gates is actually pretty safe right away.
I actually hate four gate builds, but three gate, I'm all about three gate.
Oh, three gates, a moderate build.
Yeah, it's safe. You can punish people with it. It's just a very nice build. SCV sees two Zealots, leaves.
Looks like he's hiding the Stalker here.
Maybe that, to catch
he's just
Reapers
afraid of Reapers,
well.
Yeah.
All right, Tasis, it is time for this rush to commence. But right. Oz should be.
Whoa, badly positioned there.
Nice SCV micro by Gumiho. I really like that. He almost killed that Zealot with the SCV. Via the SCV dancing, rather. Didn't want any good force fields to go off. And very smartly, Gumiho has turned around Tasis. But it looks like he is going back to his random roots. Back when he used to cheese every game. And he is going for a one base, three rack starport. Very well could be some sort of.
And look, he brought a probe out. Oh, is he actually just a fake or?
You know, three gate into expand. Very powerful build, very safe build. I like it. You like it?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm actually a crazy person. I thought you said he's getting a Stargate.
No, a start. Well, I may have called it a Stargate, but.
Oh, okay. You called the Terran player Star. Okay, so I was like, what? Like,
sorry, right. Tasteless.
No, it's okay. Like, wait a minute.
Oh, interesting. He's actually getting a reactor on the factory. So we might just see Marine Marauder Medivac off of one base. Not very common. This is something we haven't really seen for a very long time.
I think basically Team Foyu's seen the first two games. There's the corpse. Bio disintegrates quickly.
Yeah, killed his own Marine.
That was to free up supply. Because he had a supply block.
He just decimated his own army.
Is that proper usage of the word decimation?
Well, it's not exact because he didn't have 10 units there and killed one. But that is actually, people say decimate when something gets really destroyed, but it's actually a term from ancient Roman times where if the army like ran away, they would make the soldiers kill one of 10. One out of each 10 would be killed by the other soldiers with hands.
Wow.
As a punishment because they didn't want to do that. And they like bound them together. That's actually what decimate comes from. So
you're so smart.
One tenth of the army is destroyed. That's decimated.
Wow.
Jesus. He's like, I like ire. Ah, you nerd. You.
Yeah, stop.
All right.
So he's got the two medevacs out.
Some SCVs coming too.
I was just gonna be a wicked bunker pusher all in.
This is a sick all in, man. Combat shields are just gonna finish and starting to catch that.
Medivac picks it up. Oh my god, that was so good. He just spent four force fields.
Oh man, this is going to be so difficult. He has only sentries to hit medivacs with at the moment. And here we go. And one sentry going out already. You get the second sentry taken out. No more guardian shield. There you go. A guardian shield going up. SCV's coming around and tackling everything. A ton of units left for Gumiho. And this nerd is out for revenge against Z here. Just destroying FXO. Almost single-handed.
Okay, we might have an all-kill here.
Definitely a possibility.
Not the archives! Wow, this is just... Not even that upgrade's gonna finish. Look at this guy. This guy's actually a monster.
Yeah, he's up to 64 supply at 25. The game is over.
It's about to be like a Protoss blackout here where nothing's powered.
Not even any sentries left to turn their flashlights. Right now, he has 16 probes. He's not even doing anything. GG. And
wow.
Gumiho just cleaning up, man. I tell you, if StarCraft doesn't work out for him, he could become a janitor.
Oh, damn. You're funny.
Yeah, thank you. I've been trying to make you think I was actually funny.
Yeah.
I'm like trying so hard, like this is our first date, Tasteless.
I know.
I'm like telling you interesting facts and finally.
You're
I
like
get
making
a
up stories and stuff. And you're like, you know, Steven Spielberg, you're like, I know that
I'm
guy,
like,
but
you
only just saw him in a restaurant for 5 seconds and you weren't even able to talk to him.
I'm like, did you know, Tasteless, that I used to be in a gang?
A gang?
That's a good pickup line right there.
It's
like,
it's
oh,
a gang,
so
you don't make the G sound at the end.
A gang?
You said it's a gang.
Yeah, a gang.
I thought you said gang.
I did.
All right, anyways, let's just focus on how sad this moment is, how badly FXO is being
owned. It's too bad, man. Gumiho is actually just slaughtering nerds left and right. There's going to be one more try for FXO. Will it be QXC?
There's or will it be the coach?
It's like coach. It's not going to be their coach, I don't think.
Like, ah, it sucks. I'm on camera. My team is losing.
Yeah.
So I say it's going to be QXC.
They have Optic Zero, QXC, and T-Gun Live. And I would say absolutely.
We're on camera again. Sorry, hi.
I would say QXC. I would say QXC. I mean, he's a great player, man.
He's got a great bandana.
He's got the sickest bandana.
It's a good bandana. I couldn't pull that off.
Yeah, you could.
Yeah, I could. thank you.
Tasis would just take off the bandana and put it in his back pocket, hanging out partway, so that he was in a gang.
Yeah, I'm in a gang. I'm a nerd gangster. And a nerd hipster.
Yeah.
And a nerd baller.
Wow. He's just a nerd. All right. The next map will be Metalopolis. Who will be on it?
I'm going to go with QXC. We haven't seen enough QXC, and it only makes sense.
You can never see enough of QXC.
They, like, open up the cage they keep QXC in. The coach is like, kill him. And he's, like, got these crazy eyes. And he's this crazy puppeteer. He's, like, standing behind him and stuff. That's what's going to happen.
Mm-hmm. QXC never tries to run away when the cage is open. He has Stockholm Syndrome. He's like, oh, I love FXL. Like, they keep you in a cage. He's like, but I love them.
I think by the way, I just want to mention again, it was so good to see all you guys at NASL.
Yeah, that was awesome.
I want to mention it one more time just in case you guys missed some of our previous guests. Some people only watch the Team League.
By the way, IPL just started today.
Oh, yeah. Check us out at IPL.
Yeah. The minigun series against Dystar.
Yeah, check that out. Today. It was so cool because some of you guys would come up in these groups and like want us to sign stuff. But like they wouldn't know who's going to first. It was like, they'd be like, am I going to step in?
They like start bumping into each other.
Yeah, you got to be a brave nerd. Come in there. The thing about us is we're actually a little bit intimidating in person. We're intiminerds.
Intiminerds?
Intiminerd.
We're intiminerdating? What?
What was even the second part? What?
I don't...
Oh, it's like intimidating.
Yeah.
Artosis.
I tried.
Just leave the word compounding to me. All right, there are
you
friends.
You do run the word compound, Tasis. Giving all the words Kool-Aid.
Yeah, man. Oh!
He like throws his glasses on the ground and breaks them, and then he realizes, oh, wait a minute, my vision's really
I'm
bad.
I'm going to be blind this game. He just comes up behind Bo Uchoya, and he just chloroforms him because that bandana was actually dipped in chloroform. He's an assassin nerd. We're actually going to see QXC rollerblading noise.
Yeah.
Around Korea.
He's a rollerblader.
He's actually like a cool dude.
Yes.
I respect that.
His teammates
when I first got to Korea, I brought my skateboard.
That was
a terrible idea, man. Yeah. It is hard to skate in Seoul, man.
This is not a good place to skate.
No, man.
Because the
bricks they use on all the sidewalks.
Yeah,
not, skate, it's like
not just that. It's actually you think with all these buildings it would be good, but no, it's too crowded. You actually can't
you
can't grind.
Rollerblading a little bit more doable than skating.
Yeah, a little bit. Not a lot more, though,
well,
actually.
You know, Seoul's a little bit of a hilly city, so.
Yeah, unless you live near the river, don't bring them.
You young kids and you're rock and rolling your skateboards. That's not music. Turn it off. Grandpa, just learn to appreciate stuff that's not 60 years ago. All right, now. Can QXC do this? Actually, I think this is a guy who could engineer a comeback here. So we're going to see... Gumiho, you know, normally I would say he's already won three. Is he fatigued at all? I don't think so. Gumiho is looking like a Harlem Globetrotter right now.
Mm-hmm.
He is.
He's really slaying nerds, Tasis.
Yeah.
Lining nerds up and knocking them down.
He is.
He's playing bumper
He's taking
bowling.
Him to the nerd firing squad.
Yeah. He's holing one in these nerds, man.
He is.
From 50 yards.
Wow. Profound metaphors here in the GSL Team League.
He just punted a 100-yard nerd goal.
Our map is going to be Metalopolis. It's an old map. It's a good map. And it's definitely a map both these guys have a lot of experience on. Can QXC do this? All the pressure is on him. He has to come back and win the next four games, or Team Boyu will be the victor, and it will be a pretty humiliating match, taking out FXO. As I call him, just go.